Question 40, we've made it all the way to the end. So the cool part is they give us an equation down here. That's where I'm going to start with. We want to find the half-life. So half-life is how long before half of it is left. Okay, do not round, blah, blah, blah. But at the end, do the tenth. So here's our equation, strontium 90. Is a radioactive substance that decays according to the following function, where y naught is the initial amount present and y is the amount present at time t. So we want half-life. Again, we don't know what the beginning value is, but what we do know is the relationship. Whatever we started with, we only have half of it left when we're after this some time has passed. My suggestion is you could put one and then we'd have a half here. But it's easier for me to think, well, let's say we started with two. So let's say we started, why not, starts with two. What's half of two? Well, down the road, that means we're looking for when we have one left. So I'll do it that way. You could start with one and then y would be one half, right? That's probably quicker, but I'm going to say I'm looking for when do we have one, because we started with two. You could start with 100 and then you'd have 50, however you want to do it. We can make up anything we want because we are the owners of our destiny. Okay, that's the main thing. And so we want to solve for t. What we do with this was we divide both sides by 2. And this is how you always kind of see, there's the half-life. When do we have half of what we started left? It doesn't matter what you start with, you will always end up with a half over here for when we're looking at this. Now, the rate has to be negative, otherwise we're growing. So we're losing, we're decaying at a rate of 2.4%. And this is where we sort of do a reverse log dance. So when we have an exponential, so remember we did log base e of some number equals b. We did a log dance that this would be e to the b equals a. What we're going to do is the opposite. So this becomes, so we're going to switch this, is going to become the base of a logarithm. So log base e, and what gets put into the logarithm is 1/2, and that's going to be equal to the input becomes the output. Remember, this exponent becomes the answer over here, negative 0.024t. Okay, and again, this log base e, that's on the calculator as the natural log of 1/2. I'm going to do it this way, equals negative 0.024. t, so we divide by the number in front of the t, and that will give us the time, right? Negative 0.024 on both sides, negative 0.024, that's going to be what t is, and so this is what we put in the calculator right here. Natural log of 1/2 divided by that. If you remember this, a lot of times, like in chemistry, strontium 90, and physics and stuff, they teach it to you that way. Just go ahead and natural log of 1/2. And that's where that's coming from. Let's see, it's got all this distracting stuff, but anyway, let me go ahead and erase these guys here. Yeah, makes it cleaner. So we're gonna enter in natural log. Let's see, here it is, natural log of 1/2, so that's in there. If we click out here, we're going to divide that by negative 0.024. make sure you get all your decimals just correct, and we'll hit enter. So it takes to the nearest tenth, so that's 28. This is in years, right? T in years, 28.9 years, rounding up. 28.9 years. And then we have half of it. Another 28.9 years, we'll have another half will be gone. Okay, it's number 40, we're done. I highly recommend anything that you reviewed to go ahead and do a retake on this practice test. I know it takes time, but it's the best way to get you ready for the actual exam, because it contains the actual exam. The questions are in here. Just do them all, work it again until you've it becomes like second nature to you, and you'll do very well on that exam. You'll see. The numbers will be different, the questions slightly different, but they're the same types of questions. And you will do very well on the exam as long as you feel very comfortable with this practice exam, this review exam. Anything that you're still questioning or not feeling good about on this practice exam, you will see it on the actual exam, and yeah, you'll struggle on it. So that's why do the struggling now. Go back, review it till you understand. Get some tutoring. Whatever you need to do, do really well on these exams, because those, it's worth 35% of the grade. And the other, the last exam, 35% of the grade. So that's, it's a large portion of the grade, and this will help you out. Be well. Let me know if you need anything else. I wish you the best success on the exam itself. Thanks for working with me. Take care. Bye-bye.